Hi everyone! Today on Blue World Academy, I'm going to be answering more viewer questions! The questions keep coming, and I'll try to keep answering. Some of you have been asking questions that are already answered in our videos. In that case, we'll try to post a link to the video as a response to your question. As usual, I apologize in advance if I mispronounce your name. DJ Silver 64 wants to know if there's a sea creature we've always wanted to film, but we haven't had the chance yet. There are several, including the Mediterranean monk seal, the blue whale, and the orca. Speaking of orcas, Sam Plotsman wants to know if we're planning an orca segment soon. Lots of people have requested an orca video. The trick is finding a place where you can film them underwater with a reasonable chance of success. Orcas are very tricky to film underwater. It takes a lot of time and patience, which means they're an expensive subject. We aren't the BBC, and we have limited resources. We can't stay on location for a month until we get the shots. Orcas will have to wait until we have the funding to support that kind of expedition. Join our Patreon. This viewer with the unpronounceable name has asked how fish fill their swim bladder with gas. That's a very good question. In fact, fish can add and remove gas to the swim bladder, but it's done through the bloodstream. Just as a human's lungs allow gas to diffuse into and out of the bloodstream, a fish can get gas out of its bloodstream and into the swim bladder, and vice versa. The trouble is, it takes a while, so fish cannot adjust the amount of gas in their swim bladder quickly. If you catch a fish on a line down deep and pull it quickly to the surface, the gas in the swim bladder will expand rapidly and may even burst before the fish can remove the gas. Fish with swim bladders need to change depths slowly. Septimus Heap wants to know when I started my diving adventures. Well, that's a funny story. When I was in college, I needed a couple of gym credits to graduate. They offered scuba diving, so I decided to give it a try. And that changed my life. That was 1988, and I've been diving ever since. Wolf Woot asks, what's the coldest water I've been in? That's easy. 29 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 1 degree centigrade, in Antarctica. Man, is that cold. Talk about freezing your face off. Related to that, Snake Gaiman asks why the water in the Arctic and Antarctic doesn't freeze. Good question. 29 degrees is definitely below the freezing point of fresh water, but not salt water. Ocean water won't freeze until 28 degrees. And believe me, in the winter, the surface of the ocean around Antarctica does freeze, just like a Wisconsin lake. While we're talking about Antarctica, Barcode Teacup and Yang Long Nu have both asked about the cold water on my face. When you're diving in cold water, you wear a super warm neoprene hood on your head, which keeps most of your head warm and dry. Your eyes and nose are protected by your mask. So the only thing that's exposed is this little bit of skin around your lips. And then it goes numb after about 3 minutes in the water. And it doesn't bother you for the rest of the dive. I'm not sure why. If you try to go without gloves, you can't. It hurts too much. I'm not sure why your face can take it and your hands can't. That's just weird. Thanks for your awesome questions, and please keep them coming. If you haven't seen our one-hour documentary, Secrets of the Reef, watch the trailer here on YouTube. You can watch the full film on Amazon Prime or iTunes. Check it out! Until next time, thanks for watching Blue World Academy. Don't forget to subscribe! Watch out! Jolly good. Forward to that. Yeah.